to go to the show. To feel the warmth, we love confusion that space can get low. Tell me, is something eluding you, sunshine? Is this not what you expected to see? If you want to find out what's behind these cold eyes, you'll just have to claw your way through this disguise. Nice! Roll the sound effects!
Just me. You better watch out for that sticker, but it's just me, so don't worry about it. Hi. Just a little bit of just a bab noise. Don't worry about it. So welcome to the stream. This is Sunday stream. Boy, it is here. Oh, some Pink Floyd. Obviously, I've been in a bit of a Floyd mood, just because. Here, let's give you this. Just because they're great. And that's In the Flesh, from The Wall. Yeah. Almost want to listen to the whole thing. Tonight, Shovelware Showcase resumes, which will be Wii games. I might not even be able to get to all the Wii games. Some of these I might have played and I don't remember. So I'm going to need your help, your interaction as an audience. Because some of these seem kind of familiar, some don't. I don't know. One of them is sticky. You know it's good when the actual game is sticky. Oh boy. And then I check out the Devolver bootleg nonsense. And then we'll go and play some bizarre Flash games. And I may have a bonus game or two in there. So I also want to say Happy Pride Day to anyone who celebrated. Hope you had a good, safe day. All right? All right. Let's start the show, shall we? Well, actually, hang on a minute. We can't start the show without the logo. Okay, now we can start the show. So it's Shovelware Showcase. It returns. A lot of these games I've had sitting around, but a lot more of them I've had only for a week. I was at too many games, and people were just giving me trash by the handful. Just trash. Tons of it. And then also, after that, of course, before that was PAX. So I have plenty of trash that just been have given to me in person. I'm not asking for these things. I'm not putting the call out like, boy, I could sure use some shitty games. But I have them, and I'll just let you know that I thought I was done playing Shovelware on the Switch, or on the Wii. Wait a minute, Switch has still got plenty to come, trust me. I thought I had finished the Wii Shovelware Showcase library, but no, there's a lot of it. I may just be done with Data Design Interactive, but you hear that? Those are games. If you could call them such a thing. Gummy Bears. Magical Medallion. Boy, when I got this one, I knew it was going to be a fun Sunday. Vinny, you've already played the Gummy Bear Adventure game. It's a shitty side-scrolling 2D platformer already done on a previous Sunday stream. Huh. Really? Oh, no. Do I have, like, selective trauma memory? All right, well, Shovelware Showcase is over. We're doing it anyway. I've done this? I have no memory of this place. I have no recollection of this. This was 3 years ago I did this. Let's see. Hang on a minute. Maybe once I actually play the game. Did I do the mini games? Vinny, you played this. I got it because of you, actually. I've inspired a new generation of Shovelware Showcase connoisseurs at this point. Yeah, I played this. I remember this. Oh, yeah, this is bad. I don't know if I said this 3 years ago, but I love that you can hear, like, clearly, like, human shoe footsteps. Meanwhile, I'm, like, a living jello. Yeah, I remember that. Watch part 8 of Shovelware Showcase if you want to see this game. I guess it's a refresher. It's a trip down memory lane. But, Vinny, you did say that 3 years ago. Consistency is important. I don't recall if I've done the mini games. Well, there's only two available. Jesus. All right. Well, I had a very fun time playing Gummy Bears. I don't feel too bad that was a repeat, because it was only about a minute and a half of our lives. So, okay. I'm gonna have to get rid of some of these cases. I keep the discs, but the cases must be removed. They just take up too much goddamn space. Monkey Mischief Party Time. Have I played this? Someone said, oh, I thought this was a new episode of Vinesauce. Rerun? Yeah, it's a rerun. Vinny, you've played Monkey Time? Vinny, you did not play this. It's a new one. Well, Narold says I haven't played it. All these goddamn games are just kind of blending into one another, but let's see what this one is. This is a dedicated Wii. This Wii has only seen trash. Someone just said this is a filler episode. Joke's on you. They're all filler episodes. Let's see. It says here you mentioned the footsteps. Let's see. I'm gonna listen to it. This is 3 years ago now.
Okay, we need to talk about these footsteps sound effects. I am a gummy bear made out of candy and squishy.
Okay, I said a little different all those years ago. Also, my compressor was a bit different. Anyway, here's a monkey party game. Wait a minute. Wait, whoa, 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 whoa. Did you just pick a lock with a banana? Because that's ingenious. Monkey Mischief. It just cuts off. Okay, good. It's like Super Monkey Ball 2 has a really bizarre animated monkey intro. this is like the parallel to that in a shittier universe. So, create a new save file. Nope, I don't think I will. That is the worst loop ever. How did they let that happen? That's got to be some kind of glitch. Moi? No, mon. Maybe they didn't have a budget to make more music. It's really blurry, too. I know it's the Wii, but holy fuck. I hate this loop. You can even hear the click. Oh, it's so bad! No one played this game before it was released. Rocking and rolling monkey. Oh boy, I thought the worst of the worst was over for Shovelware Showcase. How long is this gonna take? Let's see if the loading time is proportionate to the amount of entertainment I actually get from the game. Throw fruit at the monkey, and soon you will find that your score will leave the other players behind. You can hear the click again. Oh, it's gonna drive me crazy. What am I supposed to do? I think I'm playing. Hang on a minute. Aim, throw. Throw fruit at the monkey and see. Oh. Oh. You just point at the monkey and shoot. That's it. Oh, this is the lowest form of monkey entertainment. I've seen monkeys throw shit at each other that was more amusing than this. This is truly low budget shovelware. Like, maybe some of the worst shit I've seen on the Wii yet. I don't even know what I'm doing. I'm aiming directly center of the screen and I'm pressing the button. That's it. Game completed. The monkey is still moving. Look, what's going on with the monkey's animations? You alright, monkey? Who made this game? Who the fuck made this game? Activision published this. What? Designed and developed first for Wii, it says on the back of the box. The zookeeper has left for the day, and the monkeys are up to no good. It's all-out mayhem, and no one, including the hippos, are safe from a little monkey mischief at this zoo. Basic reading ability is needed to fully enjoy this game. Oh, is it? It says here, each monkey has its own unique personality. 20 hilarious games for everyone. Take over the zoo in 1-4-player action. Do you see 20 minigames? So I accidentally went into the same game as a moment ago. Because it's really easy to do that. 5 games times 4 players. Oh. Vinny, are you running your overclocked Wii at the wrong speed again? This I haven't. Listen, that's the game box. There's even a manual. No, this is everything you see tonight is actually real. I have in physical form. The dev now makes mobile games. Yeah, that's not surprising. I have the instruction booklet, and it's just a rundown of not even the specific minigames. It just tells you how to delete a save game and load a save game, pretty much. This has to be bugged. The music has to be bugged. This can't be real. So we'll get a crank and press A.
Ooh.
What the fuck is this?
Oh.
Game's bad. It's giving me a headache on top of it being really bad. That's cool. Let's go. Go up. Go up, monkey. 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 More loading times than gameplay. Oh, tonight is a night. One must drink. Vinny, the music is bugged. I checked gameplay and it has full audio tracks. Okay. Well, so then this is just my particular brand of shovelware shittiness. I don't know if it's the game or the Wii. For the record, this was not the game that was sticky in the collection. That would be... The honors of the sticky game goes to Rudolph, the red-nosed reindeer. I don't know if I played that one. This music is great. This is fucking insanity. Between me laughing and the rest of the overload. I don't know what's happening. Oh, God. Oh, I see. You have to, I'm using Scorpion's grappling hook to reel in steak.
Oh.
Get over here! I won.
Oh.
Oh. Oh. Boy. Someone told me to clean off the sticky Wii game with soap and water, possibly. Salmon Slap. Oh wait, no, there are more games. This is one of the worst. Right out the gate. Let's forget Gummy Bears ever happened twice. But yeah, this is a bad one. Is it okay if I use Axe body spray to clean my Wii discs? Everybody, is that fine? Oh. Like, I could just see the Wii disc, you know, it's filthy, it's sticky, and then I put the Axe body spray on it, and then it gets sunglasses. Oh, this is a fart minigame. Oh. I see. I see. Kind of makes you appreciate the Mario music and sound effects, huh? Like for Mario Party? I can only go to the right? What the fuck? I don't know what's happening. Oh God, it's just such ass. Can we go back to Gummy Bears? Gummy Bears seems like a fucking masterpiece. Vinny, I sent you the Rudolph game 2 years ago and it was clean when I sent it to you. What hellhole has that disc been in for the past 2 years? It grew fungus. The disc itself grew some kind of sticky fungus on it. Harry Houdini. Let me just breathe in the fungus. I feel fine. Just as the music is about to get started. What is that? What does that represent? I don't know what that represents. Battery charge is running low. When the battery runs out, so too do the shovelware games. This monkey's gone to heaven. This monkey's gone to heaven. Someone said this game... Someone put their blood, sweat, and tears into this game. Have a little respect. I believe that people did sweat on the disc. Correct? I do believe that. Throw the hippo with all of your might and hope that it has a really good flight. Get that message a lot. Oh, it's Mario 64, but worse. Music. Someone just said, Flight of the Blue Bald. Wow, what are the odds of the AI throwing that hippo into the exact same spot twice in a row? Oh, fuck. Uh-oh. This is something else. I mean, it's just extra shitty with the music looping like this. But even without shitty music loops, this game would be like a Hall of Famer. I think this is gonna go, if I had to like go through all my Shovelware Showcase videos and give you like the top 10, I'd probably put all of the Data Design games in there, and then that would leave room for like 2 or 3. Finally, this one actually sounds good. This is the best loop so far. Even though it kind of honks. Ah! Wait, is this time to take a piss? How do I piss? They're pissing. Yep. Just peeing on birds. That's how I like to spend my Sunday night. Like to piss on some birds. And you have to shake. You have to shake to piss. You know, like, when you're about to finish peeing, well, some of you will know about this. When you're about to finish peeing, you have to do the shake maneuver. You know what I mean? The shake? That's what I'm doing right now to my fucking nunchuck. This game hurts. This is a painful video game. Shake, shake. Just remember, they couldn't make the liquid pee. Like, they had to make it look like something else, but it was most certainly pee. Oh no. Oh no! It's just orgasms. Okay, all right. Okay. I have to play a game. You combine the music with the sound effects of the monkeys, and it sounds like a My stomach hurts. Oh, fuck. Physically laugh anymore. Oh. Jesus Christ. I lost it. I fucking lost it. What is this? What the fuck? I'm gonna get electrocuted! I'm gonna get electrocuted for failing! Holy fuck. Okay, I'm gonna draw a banana. God damn it! How the fuck did you get that kind of accuracy with the Wiimote? There's a monkey noise. The monkey noises. Oh, God. Oh, fuck. I wish I would have played this last. How the fuck do I follow this game? I follow this! Oh. I got tears in my eyes. Bathroom chaos. Oh no. Oh no! Why are they coming out of toilets? Oh, to be a fly on the wall of the recording session where they did the monkey noises. I don't understand the correlation between shaking the nunchuck and reloading toilet paper. Fuck, I hate the Wii sometimes. Vinny, there's literal shit on the wall to the right. I didn't see it. Was there really shit on the wall? Monkey see, monkey do. I believe it. I believe there was shit. I believe that a programmer put shit on the wall in this game. More people are watching this now than have bought the game in its entire, like, run. Well, I don't... These fucking noises. I feel like a tool. I'm barely doing the things. It's just kind of doing them on its own. Yeah, I was winning. Bump 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 bump. This company went on to make 5 more games. Excuse the fuck me. I need to find those other games. This is like Data Design Interactive levels of amazing. Are they the new Data Design? What is the name of this developer? It's Activision published it. Who made this fucking trash? Who's the developer? I can't, like, they're not even advertising on the box who the developer is. I'm looking. I still don't see a goddamn developer for this. That's astounding. Satan? Oh. Good. I like getting physically tired when I play my video games. Yes! This is just Temple Run. This is just shitty Temple Run. I've given up. Yo, the worst part is there's still, like, how many mini games have I not played? 2, 2, 2, 8. I've only played 12 of 8 mini games. The rest are unlockables. Oh no. Did I say 12 of 8? You know. Fuck. You know what I mean. 12 of 20. 12 of 8. I am the Borg. My designation is 12 of 8. Yeah, I gotta see who made this nonsense. This is important. Activision Value Publishing. The word value. Great value video games.
Do you think my name can be left out of the... out of the credits, please? I don't want to be in there.
Joe Hedges. You have to be in the credits. You helped make our game. We're gonna make a lot of money. We only spent $14 on it. We'll make at least 20 times that.
No, I'd prefer not to have my career assassinated by this game. Also, my name is Nathan Fielder.
QA testing, that's interesting. Wow. Yeah, that's Shovelware Showcase history for me. That's a top five. Easily top five. And some of the best laughs I've ever gotten from shitty Wii games. Though, there was just a moment of serendipity here, because if the music wasn't as crusty and looping, and the music was actually functional, I might not have lost my shit as much as I did. So... have I played Sea Monsters, A Prehistoric Adventure? If anyone knows. I'm going to need your help on some of this stuff. No, I don't think I have. Have I played Impossible Mission? I feel like I might have played this. I have not. Mission Impossible. Impossible Mission. Ivolgamus is the name of the developer. Activision Value Publishing made Big Rigs. Oh, fun. Fun times in Value High. It's, listen, I don't know if I've played Impossible Mission. Someone just gave this to me. I have it. Unopened. Codemasters made this one. I'll play that fucking great value Sea Monsters game, America's Value, in a little bit, but you gave this to me, Alizarin? Alright. Well, here we fucking go. There's a dude on the cover that looks like Ethan Hunt from Mission Impossible, but he's got like an orthopedic scope on his head, and it's really JPEG'd out. Like, the quality of this cover is really fucking bizarre. Because the main character looks pretty good, but his gadget is JPEG. And he looks like a bootleg Sam Fisher, so... you wanna see it? Alright. Impossible Mission Wii. You might not see it exactly as I'm seeing it. But, yeah. I mean, you can kind of tell. Like, if you look closely... look at the tool. Look at like, how it's, like, boxy. You know, it's like boxes. And then, you know, the rest of it is a little bit better. I don't know how to explain it. It's weird. I don't like it, is what I'm trying to say. I don't like it. Wow. Okay, for comparison purposes, look at how they stretched the main character to, like, double his length. Why would you do that? Yeah, impossible mission. If we change the words around, we can maybe fool some people into thinking this is Mission Impossible. There he is again. The one piece of art they have. Ooh, crusty. Oh, we got lens flare, too. I don't know if I played this. I still don't know if I played this already. New classic merged. This is based on an older game. What? Oh my god. It's a mixture of Agent Smith and Neo. It's a mixture of the T-1000, or, you know, Terminator 2's Liquid Man, and, whatever. Shitty RoboCop. Yeah, a little Bender in there, too. The top is Bender from Futurama. And this is just Heather Locklear. Vinny, this was originally a game for the Commodore 64.
Stay a while. Stay forever!
Well, thank God it's back. After all these years. It's back, everybody! We've been waiting so many long years for Impossible Mission. Okay. I am having fun. Back in my day when the game was the game. I don't think I need to tell you, chat, but the controls are not very good. I don't even know what that stuff is down there.
Hey! Where my shiny metal ass?
That's Bender. That's him. Someone said this doesn't look too bad, honestly. It's not Monkey Game. It's pretty fucking crusty, though. Vinny, why does this guy look like ABGN? Holy fuck, he does. From a distance, it looks like Angry Video Game Nerd. Ass! I'm gonna have to pass this game along when I'm finished with it, let's say. It's got like an interlinked overworld a little bit, so that's something. Cells within cells, interlinked. Or as I like to call it at conventions, it smells within smells, interstinct. I just want to go back to the menu, man. Let me just reset. Vinny, there's no way you came up with that yourself. You're either giving me no credit or too much credit. That wasn't even that funny. But yeah, I think I did. A couple years ago, I came up with that. Vinny, how do I fast forward? Oh, no, 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 no. There is no fast forward feature when you watch live. You have to sit through more impossible missions. Sorry. This time, we're doing merged.
Another visitor! Stay a while! Stay forever!
I'm good. I'm good. Wait. Someone said the original has digitized voices? Okay, hang on a minute. I want to check out classic mode then. So yeah, the Sea Monsters game. I definitely haven't played Sea Monsters Prehistoric Adventure. Doesn't look like I have. I don't know, I remember I played some underwater adventures on Shovelware Showcase. I guess not that one. Takes a long time to load into this. Okay, here's the classic mode. I guess this is what the game originally looked like. I don't know how faithful it will be.
Another visitor! Stay a while! Stay forever!
I was expecting a heavily digitized voice. So that's not the original voice at all. I mean, yeah, if you're a kid in the 80s and you have this, it might be kind of fun to use your imagination, like in Muppet Babies. I'm sure it's not that bad if you're a kid in the 80s. But right now, I'm a kid in the 90s. What? Here's the original voice.
Another visitor. Stay a while. Stay forever.
I like that so much better. Anyway, yeah, the original looks exactly like this. Hang on a second, what are we doing here? What do you want me to do, chat? Okay, yeah, I can do that. That's cool. Let me do something like that. Okay. That's the first picture I have available. Actually, that's not true. Hang on a minute. Did you ever play Impossible Mission Taco? Where is that? Where is that taco image? Yep, here it is. Sunday stream. I gotta keep that taco image on the desktop. You never know when you're gonna need a gorilla inserting a taco in and out of its mouth. Now the game is better. Now the game is easily done. Look at Milhouse's legs. The game is so much better. Oh shit. Wrong chroma color. Aw, oh, damn. Fuck.
blue.
Oh my god, it's so much more cursed now. That's enough of this. So there's almost zero entertainment value to be had in this game. At least for a Sunday stream. Again, if you're a kid in the 80s, I'm sure it's wonderful to have that. You can jump and you can run, you can laugh, you can cry. You can do anything you want. What the fuck was that? Did you see that? It said copy protected content? That was built into my capture card. What the fuck? Huh. I don't know. HDCP? I don't know what that means. Well, while I'm changing games, I'd like to tell you something.
Well, it seems today that all we see is violence and movies and sex on TV.
But we're at old, good, old-fashioned values.
Oh, I have a video from the convention I forgot to show you. It's a slime I was given in slow motion. You ready? Look at that slime right there. Yeah. Yeah, look at that. Get in there. Sea monsters. It says here in the wow, there's like two full okay, wait, no, it's one big paragraph, the rest is French. In the oceans of Earth millions of years ago, danger was never far away, and monsters lurked in every shadow. Experience this astounding world by playing as six different prehistoric marine reptiles, each with special skills. From extreme speed to thick armor and powerful crunching jaws. Nat Geo, what? Take on foes, hunt for prey, unlock hidden challenges. Take control of your first sea monster and begin your adventure. Okay. I mean, it sounds cool.
World of Sea Monsters brings together some of the fiercest and most incredible prehistoric marine reptiles to have ever lived. Oh.
I think it said not all creatures existed at the same time. Prehistoric creature? It's weird going... Oh, too deep. Okay. I almost killed my prehistoric creature. That would have been bad. Wait, what's your deal? Are we fighting? I don't have a fight button. It's like underwater Star Fox. It's not actually attacking. I don't have an attack button. Oh, wait. I think I do. Wait, I might. Is this a mating mini game? I don't know, man. Very confusing. Creature found. Health boosted. Unlocking new monsters allows you to swim deeper. Alright, well, rest in peace. This isn't, like, so bad that it's terrible. It's bad in a way that it's kind of just boring. Even though the concept is really cool. Thalassomadon. Thalassomadon. It's a slow moving, and they can swim with a great stealth to sneak up on the prey. Stuck with the damn Thalassomadon. Dom, dom, bom, bom. One hard. Yeah, just a long boy. I'm very bored. The music plays, and then there's like points where you could lock onto an enemy, but I can't do anything. I don't think my Thalassomadon can actually attack. That's my current guess. Though this does run smoother and look better than the Switch port of Ark. So I'll give it that. Grab that fossil. I see. Yeah, I get it. You just gotta build... You gotta build your lizards. I saw a crab. How do I shoot? What? The fuck? Chat, I can't play this anymore. I'm fucking bored to tears by this game. And I'm lacking the stamina. You have to point and click and hold B for attacks. I was doing that, but it was just turning me around. The B button... Alright, let me try one more time to attack. I can protect, but I can't attack. What I need to do is, I need to eat the turtles. See? I hold the button, and it just ends up with my ba-ba-ba-da-ba-don turning around. And then the next stretch. Don't like it. I don't want it. I never have. I... Okay, that was Sea Monsters, the quest for... Let's see, press your luck, 2010 edition. Let's go with, Rudolph. I've had this game for 2 years. Fuck it. Fuck it, we'll play Rudolph. It was sticky. It was mainly sticky on the, it was like 80% inside the cover. So it's mostly not sticky. But if my Wii no longer plays games after this, it's for the best. So here's Moldy Rudolph, the red-nosed reindeer, just in time for Halloween. My favorite holiday, Halloween.
Hold the Wii remote like this.
Well, Halloween is the beginning of Christmas, as we all know. What? I've never seen that one before. Let me get some de-interlacing. No, we most certainly do not need to save this video game. It's amazing how all the shittiest games on the Wii have very similar menus. Oh, they actually have license to use the characters from the Rudolph. They're not like bootlegs. Also, why is the sound
late? Welcome to Christmas Town, also known as the North Pole. Let me introduce myself. I'm Sam the Snowman. Nice to meet you. What? Haven't you heard of a talking snowman before? Well now, you got here just in time. Santa needs your help decorating his tree and filling his bag of toys for Christmas.
Great value
Where
voice
is
acting.
Santa, you ask? Why, he's just up the road a bit. First castle on the left. Well, the only castle on the left. Hurry along now. Santa and the elves are waiting.
I'm so sorry. You didn't deserve that.
Help get ready for Christmas. You need to decorate and put presents under the tree, and also put toys in Santa's bag. Bounce the items to the crook's side by jumping under them as they fall. Tilt the Wii remote left and right to move, and the Wii remote.
Imagine Sam the Snowman telling you to tilt the Wii remote. But yep, that's how I play this. It's not left or right, it's tilt. The Wii Shovelware showcases are truly wretched. Vinny, you played this before? Again, I have no memory of this place.
Misfit toy for Santa's bag.
Maybe a different guy streamed this? Is it possible another dude with a hat and facial hair streamed this? Joel played it? Oh god.
Bounce it under the tree.
Do people still not know the difference? You chat, I'm gonna set the record straight. Once and for all, for real. Because I still get this all the time. And I don't think... I think maybe 60% of the people are joking, but 40% don't realize that there's a difference between me and Joel. We are two separate human beings. Joel is not some kind of weird alter ego that I have, or a secondary channel that I have. And vice versa. Now you know, the record has been set straight. However, V-Dub and I are two completely separate people. As well. That's another rumor I'd like to squash.
This goes under the tree. This goes on the tree. Misfit toy for Santa's bag.
What is the gingerbread man doing on the left there? Did you see that? That was weird. What the fuck kind of maneuver was that? What is he doing? He's rubbing something on himself.
Great job, concert is over.
Holiday Kelper.
You did a fine job up at the castle. There are many toys waiting to be finished.
I'm gonna play as Link.
Big night, and time is running short. Could you go over to Santa's toy shop and help paint the toys? Help paint the toys! Paint the toys when they glow by moving the Wii remote up and down like a paintbrush.
Budget Christmas music. Budget Christmas voice acting. Wait, what am I... What? Oh, no. Yeah, that's... The controls are... Oh, no. Okay, so you automatically lock onto the thing, and then you just shake the Wiimote once, and it automatically throws the thing at the thing. This is not challenging or fun.
I'm a dentist!
Why would you shout, I'm a dentist, after painting a toy? What?
Nice work! I'm a dentist!
That's like me pinching a particularly good loaf and I'm proud of it, and I'm like, I'm a streamer!
I'm a dentist! Nice work! Nice work! Nice work! Perfect!
Like, I know the story of Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. I know Link, Blue Link, is actually a dentist. His name is Hermes, right?
Perfect! Perfect!
I'm a gamer!
I'm a dentist! Perfect!
Nice work! The toys are ready for Christmas!
I mean, it's a shame, because they got the characters looking kind of like the movie. Maybe if they spent time making more than a minigame collection. Also, I don't know if there's a desync in the game, or if it's just my life that's desynced right now, but the sound effects are not lining up with the visuals.
The toys are ready for children all over the world. What's next, you ask? Why, cookies, of course! I see the elves have started to bake. You should get... Help make Christmas cookies for Santa. Move the Wii remote.
I am Santa.
Make lots of delicious cookies for Santa. The picture will help show you what to do as well.
The gingerbread man tutorial is amazing. Boy, this is the opposite of fun.
Delicious! Nice job!
Jenny... I need... the cookie.
I am now just shaking the Wiimote in a circular fashion. In fact, I'm swinging it. I am now swinging it, from the wire that's attached to the nunchuck. I'm just swinging it around like a helicopter. Let's see if that's good enough.
Nice job. Delicious.
I'm losing my power, Jimmy. Give me, I need, ah.
Wow, it does work. It works if you just swing it around in a helicopter motion. Vinny, that's unsafe. Like, don't you look at the pick before you play any Wii game? Oh, I got a wrist strap on, don't worry. It's fine. Well, again, the game is conflicting because it both looks good and plays bad. Like, the license... They got it visually. The voice actors didn't, but they didn't probably pay them. Or they paid them in cookies. Press Your Luck 2010 edition. This has got a very shiny... It's a very shiny case. Ubisoft published this. And... It's brand new. I don't think this has been played... yeah, it's got some thumbprints on it. Never mind. Did you ever wonder what was on those thumbs before... You know?
I'm a dentist!
Oh, here's your reminder. Shovelware Showcase. Shovelware Showcase. Shovelware Showcase.
Oh, thank you. Here we go. Yeah, there it is. I was wondering where the gorilla taco was. Oh. Thanks.
Is this the whammy game? People are saying it's whammy game. Yeah, well, we're pressing our luck by playing the game. You're pressing your luck watching my stream. I'm pressing my luck streaming these games. Oh, right. It's the whammy game. I remember there was a dude who figured out how to do the whammy game, and he cheated the system. I remember that. I remember those game. And it's time for human beings. Let us be human beings together. Look at these human beings, everyone. This one looks like a villain, the bottom right. I don't know why. It's good. His name is now Wattler. That's his name, and he will be winning the money. No whammy. What? Say what was that? Is that almost a word? I don't think I've ever watched an episode of this.
Press your luck. Here's okay. The first question. What group of people were exiled from the Louisiana colony in 1724? Give us your answer.
Basketball players? What?
So what is it?
What chat? What if? Oh, this is a heavy one to start with.
Time's up. Sorry, you. Can't
I don't know.
Get any spins for that question? These are the three possible answers. Player one, let's hear your response.
It's got to be the Jewish settlers.
This answer. Player three.
It's not basketball players. And why would royalty be exiled from Louisiana?
The answer is Jewish settlers. One spin.
Holy.
One.
cocks and balls. What a question to start with. Fuck off.
To the next question. Who was the first British monarch to address the U.S. Congress?
Who is the dictator that killed thousands of people? Hundreds of thousands of people. The correct answer is Pol Pot.
As always, we have
cool topics. Thanks.
Answers. Give us your answer.
I'm going to say...
You can do it.
I don't know.
Let's hope it's good. Player three, your answer? Let's hope it's good. The correct answer is Queen Elizabeth II. Player two gets one spin. Player three gets one spin. Moving on to the next question.
Spin!
Josh Groban appeared and sang on what 2001 television show?
Well, these shows... I don't know who Josh Groban is!
Let's hear player one's answer. Let's hope it's good. Let's check out the three possibilities. Let's hear your response.
I don't know.
You only have a few sec. Good answer.
The David Gilmour girls.
Do you have an answer for us, player three? Good answer. The correct one is Ally McBeal. Player one gets three spins.
Shit.
Let's take a look at the
Vinny, how do you
question.
Not know? I don't remember.
The Guggenheim Museum is located
okay, well,
in which city?
I know this one. Oh, I had to actually hit
Player
the thing.
One,
it's New York.
What's your answer? Okay, this is your answer. Let's check out the three possibilities. What's your answer? Let's hope it's good. Player three? Good answer. The correct one is New York.
I'm having fun.
Player one. Player two gets one spin. Lots of spins, lots of bucks. Let's go to the big board round.
Man, player one is going to win.
Let's go to the big board. But remember, if the whammy is what you see, you'll
I think I've been to the Guggenheim. I don't fucking remember.
Player two and player one will play last. It's your go, player two. Will you pass it along?
No, I want to spin.
$700.
Holy shit.
Will you pass it along or spin?
Nah, I'm gonna do this.
$550.
I'm rich.
It's your go, player three. What will it be? Spin or pass?
Do I stop now?
$600.
Was there voice acting?
What will it be? Spin or pass?
The voice.
$600.
It was like big box,
big box stop. No whammy.
Will
big box stop.
Or pass? Big box. Come on. A whammy.
Look at that. Oh, that sucks, dude. You whammied.
Your first whammy. What will it be? Spin or pass?
No whammy.
A whammy.
Yo, dude. You suck, bro.
Your second whammy. Don't worry, keep it up. What will it be? Spin or pass?
Big box. Big box. No whammies. Come on.
Damn it.
$500. Will you spin or pass?
Big box.
Why is the mixing of the contestants so goddamn low?
$500 and one extra spin. What will it be? Spin or pass?
Big box.
You just skip through all of that. I mean, the fun is getting the whammies. I've had so much fun.
Let's take a look at the first question. Who is the Roman god of war?
Mars? Oh, I gotta actually hit the thing.
Let's hear your response. Let's hope it's good. Let's check out the three possibilities.
I keep forgetting that I have to hit the buzzer.
Okay, this is your answer. Player three's answer is... Good answer. The correct one.
Nah,
is...
dude, it's Minerva! Dude!
Alright,
I'm gonna stop playing this in a moment. I have more shovelware. I have more trash. I don't want to get stuck on whammy.
What player did Phoenix Suns forward Raja Bell clothesline in the 2006 NBA playoffs?
Oh, yeah, that's easy. I'll remember fucking obscure basketball trivia from 2006. No problem.
Let's hear player one's answer.
Smush Parker?
You gave this answer. As
always,
oh,
he's gone.
Possible
I'll see
Let's
you, Smush.
Hear your answer.
Was it Kobe? I know
okay,
the name Kobe.
This is your answer.
I know Kobe.
Do you have an answer for
it's
us,
Kobe.
Three?
I don't know. I don't know.
You gave this answer. The correct one is Kobe Bryant.
Hell yeah, I am a champion.
Gets one spin.
I was hoping it would be Smush. Question.
A vaccine to prevent what terrible disease was invented in the U.S. in 1952?
And subsequently demonized in 2019.
Player one, polio. What's your answer? Good answer. As always, we have three possible answers. Let's hear your answer. Okay, this is your answer. Player three's answer is... Okay, this is your answer.
Player three, excuse me?
Polio.
Excuse me, that's 30 years before that.
One spin for player two. Moving on to the next question. What is a leek?
It's a vegetable. What are these questions?
Player one's answer.
It's a mild
As
onion.
Always, we have three
it's a Miku's
answers.
Weapon of choice.
Let's hear your answer. Good answer. Player three, your answer. Good answer. The correct one is a mild onion.
It's an onion.
One spin for player two. Take us to the big board.
Why am I still playing this?
Here's the final round. Time for a big finish. We'll start with player one, and player two will play last. Time to press your luck, player one. What will it be, spin or pass? No way.
I'll just skip their turn. Oh, zero, dude. Oh, man, I gotta beat 6,200. All right, let's do it. Let's spin. Here it is. It's time to win. Spin to win.
Will you pass it along or spin? $1,000 and one extra spin.
Oh,
will you
shit.
Spin or pass? Advance two spaces. You win, you won a trip.
I want a vacation.
$4,000.
Wait, where am I going?
What will it be? Spin or pass? Go back two spaces. You win $5,000.
A virtual
and
vacation.
One extra spin. Will you spin or pass? A whammy.
Oh no, look, it's a funny whammy. Shit. Wow.
Ouch. Uh-oh. Number one. What will it be? Spin or pass?
Well, there goes all my money. Do I still get the vacation? I want to go on a virtual vacation to prehistoric underwater land. Sorry, better luck next time. You fucking suck. Vinny, I told you to pass. Aw, oh, damn. Shit, chat member. I wish I would have seen it. Yeah, I think I got the money value of the vacation, and I didn't get a virtual vacation. So why don't we go on a vacation together, Chat Yacht? You and I, together, will go to... Where are we going? Tell them where they're going. They're going to... movie studio! Okay, we're going to movie studio. Attack of the Movies 3D. Now, I don't think I've streamed this one. This one might be a little bit more well-known than some of the other ones I've streamed. Includes four pairs of 3D glasses. Except there are zero pairs of 3D glasses. So whoever previously owned this game kept the glasses and then just threw the game out. Which was then picked up by a muskrat and brought to the local GameStop. GameStop fed the muskrat one piece of corn. And here we are. Vinny, is the audio out of sync? Yes. I mean, it doesn't really matter, does it? Here, let me fix it.
Where are we going?
Tribute.
Insect invasion. Oh, I'm doing it in 3D.
Flick the Wii Zapper downward to reload. Oh god, I don't have a Wii Zapper.
Neutralize any nearby insect threats and exterminate the giant scorpion.
What, like ants?
3, 2, 1, action!
Immediately I'm shooting giant ants, my people. It'd be nice if reload was bound to a different thing.
Oh my god.
So by the way, this stream is now 3D, so if you have 3D glasses, now's the time. Never mind. Well, this is less bad than most of the other shovelware I played. Wow, big scorpion boss and everything. Hey, if you have your 3D glasses ready, let me know, because that way I can... I can turn 3D back on for you. Yeah, there are people in the audience that claim they have a pair currently, so... Do you, though? Do you really? You ready? Get ready to be sucked into the world of ants.
Triple shot.
What does it look like? Is it crazy? Is it awesome?
Triple shot, triple shot.
I don't think I was supposed to do that. Actually works, but it's shit. Oh.
Neutralize any nearby insect threats and exterminate the giant scorpion.
Well.
3.
I don't feel like playing through all this.
2.
Because, you know, reasons. Into the Emperor's Tomb 3D Cosmic Combat. Robot Rebellion, Deep Sea Danger, and Haunted... Oh man, is there a cheat code for this? Can anyone look up cheat codes? Attack of the Movies 3D. The Movies 3D Codes. This has a rating of 39% on GameFAQs. It's, there's one cheat, Mega Shot. It's like pickups. Scroll through until you reach a locked item.
Mega shot.
Wow. There actually is a goddamn cheat code. That's it. That's the only code in the game. So, the thing I need, which is to unlock all of the levels. That's not real. We made it up.
Neutralize any nearby insect threats and exterminate the giant scorpion. 3, 2, 1, action.
Well, I mean, there's a 4-player mode, so you could, you know, you could get some people together and play.
might be worth a couple bucks. Of all the games I played tonight, this is probably the only one I can see myself playing for any extended time. Like an hour? Half hour?
Reload!
Gonna need that mega shot. Vinny, dual-wield Wiimotes. That is a stupid, stupid idea, and it's fantastic. I'm gonna do exactly that. I'm gonna do that, but I have to put batteries in this one, because my batteries die in Wiimotes. Anyone else have that fun issue? I mean, I know you're not supposed to leave batteries in something for too long anyway, but did anyone else over the years discover that the Wiimote is like a forbidden battery suck? See, I only hope there's no crust on... No, we didn't get battery leakage or crust. Oh, wait, yes, we did. Yeah, this Wiimote. Oh, boy, there's juice. Uh-oh. What is this juice? I don't like that. I'll be right back, chat. Uh-oh.
Uh-oh. Battery acid leak. Didn't see battery acid on the roof because there was no battery acid on the roof. The reactor does not explode. I'm sure it's gonna be fine, chat. I'm just putting some new batteries in here. I'm sure it's gonna work, and it'll be great. And these batteries will one day also crustify. Yep, it's good.
It is good. I don't know how much of that you heard, but...
Yeah.
Oh my god, it works.
Triple shot.
Reload, reload.
Yes.
Triple shot. Shot. Mega shot.
Ah, I'm fucking a mega. Mega awesome!
Space aim. Spirit bonus.
You can tell which one I'm using without with my non-dominant hand.
Triple shot.
I mean, what Hollywood movies are there with giant ants? Or like giant insects? Checkpoint. It was Eight-Legged Freaks? Was there anything else? Evolution kind of had big bugs. Ant-Man. But they weren't enemies. Well, they kind of were. Why am I still playing this? It's like the previous game. I couldn't stop playing it. Helicopter? Is that a bad helicopter? No, it's a good helicopter. I think... Get in!
Score bonus.
extra life.
This is a hell of an experience. Seeing two Wiimotes at the same time is very, very strange. But also kind of challenging and fun. I know. I can't believe I just said that, but it's true. Try it for yourself, everyone. It kind of works. You have to, like, separate your brain. It's like, oh, I'm dead. We will never see the other games. Or the other levels. Sorry. Man, and this Deep Sea Danger one and the Haunted House, those seem good. And my Wiimote is dying. My other one. Vinny, please turn off 3D. I forgot it was on. I'm pretty sure my brain is now experiencing... It's experiencing some kind of split. Like, there's a schism in my brain happening. And it also... Like, the fact that the 3D was happening, my eyes are probably also rotting. Like, they're fucking... Like, it's necrotic flesh now. Good. Again, not the worst game I've played on Shovelware Showcase. In fact, you can get some entertainment out of that for a couple minutes. So that's okay. Have I played I Spy? I think I have. I have. I Spy, goodbye. Press your luck, goodbye. I don't want to do a dancing game. I'll save that for another Shovelware Showcase. Alright, I'll end with this. I think I've had this sitting around for a while. This one's good. Oh, shit. I thought that was his penis. This is pretty much Phoenix Wright. Okay. See, I have some other ones over here, too. What do I have? Chicken Shoot, I know I played that. I have a lot of PS2 games for the next Shovelware Showcase, including several fishing games, which I would prefer not to play. I have PS3 game, Gabagool Showcase. What is this? I don't know. I got Sports Champions. Oh, I found a really interesting video. Someone sent me a video today. I don't know what the fuck this was, but... Some gabagools. Arguing about pizza.
I got a question for you. What was important last night in order to put this pie?
There was 8 slices.
Okay.
Amongst us two.
So just so you get the visual, I'm sitting here.
Give your honest opinion.
Sitting here.
You're right in front of your 4 slices.
Right. Okay.
Okay.
So I ate this corner.
He ate that one first.
He ate this corner.
I
don't know what. I don't know what the fuck.
He ate that one. Yes. Right. I ate this one.
Yes.
Right. He skipped that one.
I don't. Maybe I didn't want them. Maybe I wanted the corner.
He skipped that one.
I went to the corner.
Stood up and. Took mine.
Oh, I didn't stand up nothing because if
he
you
reached across,
I grabbed the
and he
corner.
Took
well,
my
was this corner bigger? No, it was smaller. As a matter of fact, that's why I took it.
You should have ate the pizza on your red table.
I could take a pizza.
No, you
it's
can't.
Mine.
That was
no, you can't.
You.
You're wrong.
You chose
you
that
took
side.
My half.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did.
I ate
started.
My side.
This
I ate four. My side.
No, you didn't. This four.
You me.
I had
you,
this side.
Me.
You took. So now I want.
Your side! It's not proper pizza etiquette!
What do you know about etiquette?
You're wrong, Mario! You're wrong!
It's a pizza!
You're wrong!
Of course his name is Mario.
I understand you're both upset over the great pizza caper here.
No, I'm
not
upset.
But let's relax. And somebody's here now. There's a piece of growing up on a lot.
I don't know what that was. With no context, it's even better.
Do you really want to feel him? Harvey Attorney, habeas corpus, Marvin Attorney! Harvey Birdman, Attorney at Law!
Man, they should do more shit like this. Take these old school cartoon characters and give them a strange profession, like talk show host, Space Ghost, or lawyer, Attorney at Law, Harvey Birdman. I don't know why they're not doing more of this. Scooby-Doo can run like some kind of like, I don't know, like a kitchen. Shaggy could be like, a fucking like a recovery counselor.
You damn twig snappers! People are trying to sleep!
Or they run a dispensary, that's fine.
The start of a weenie roast. I need to get me some kielbasa and white hots!
Okay.
Seven-letter word for long and hard. Starts with an A. What is this? I know this. What would be long and hard?
Ayo Kaub.
Arduous! And it's a little long, and all those vowels make it hard.
Okay.
Birdman!
Okay, I know the battery's running low. Fuck!
You're half of the duplex! It burned down!
Peter Potamus, you're under arrest for the arson of this guy's half a house!
Harvey, help me! I didn't do it!
Yep. I gotta get more batteries, because this is just gonna keep getting interrupted. And, the batteries are too far away. I can't reach. This might not be Shovelware Showcase material. This is apparently good. Remember that. So I don't know if I'm going to play it for a long time, but I might attempt one more Shovelware after this, or I might end it with this. Again, there's just no topping the Monkey Game. Monkey Game was too good. I still have the Flash Trash, so I can show you that in a bit.
Well, I mean, if I was going out, so I'd throw your mailbox in and keep it going a bit longer for my s'mores.
Without context, this is weird.
But I didn't start it!
Ordinarily, I turned down a case while busy with something else. But seeing how this hippo saved me in a case, I need a good lawyer, now!
Hey, anybody got an extra set of trousers? Damn intern, rip my good chinos!
Save me!
Yeah, sure.
And even save my life.
Birdman's drowning! All right, what'd I do? What'd I do?
Fuck.
What are you-
1,000! 2,000!
I have to. I'll take the case!
What am I looking at? Was that- Wait a minute. Was that the actual voice of Harvey Birdman? Sorry, I had a little stroke.
I'll take the case!
That's the it's Gary Cole? No shit. Wow. That's Lumberg.
Did you
get- I'll take the case. I've already taken the case.
Okay, what now,
Volturo?
Birdman, is it not enough that you taste by having your duplex? Now you have to suffer by losing to me.
That was me a minute ago.
Oh, Henry.
Oh, cute. An air kiss. Followed by an air fondle, air squeeze, and then finally an air...
Order! Order in the courtroom!
Wait a minute. That was...
Presenting evidence.
What the fuck is this? I've never seen this show before. I should have watched this show. an old-fashioned record album, Squawking Heads, Burning Down Your House. Fire started around 11 p.m., burned for about 2 hours before emergency vehicles showed up. By then, the duplex was burned to the ground. Book of Matches from Boobies. It has Potamus's name and phone number handwritten inside. Yeah, yes.
Thank you, Your Honor. Now, I would like to... Mr. Peter Potamus to the stand.
Okay, don't say anything. Got it? The less you say, the better our case.
Now, Mr. Potamus, if you wouldn't mind, jury,
total
and complete guilt in this case.
I am sorry. I will not admit to anything because I have a bad case of laryngitis.
He's just this thing.
Therefore, I cannot talk. Good day then.
But you just, I mean, this is preposterous. Your Honor, if I could, I demand the defendant admit to the crime. I demand it.
Mr. Bam Bam, does your defendant have laryngitis?
Does Potamus have laryngitis? No.
I think he meant to say bronchitis. Wait, that's the seven-letter word beginning with A.
Yeah, what he said.
You mean an inflammation of the bronchial tubes caused by excessive smoke inhalation. Laughable. No further questions, Your Honor. He did it.
Well, looks like I lost.
Yeah, Mr. Bombs over Baghdad, you're up.
Ladies and gentlemen, sure, my client appears to be a callous, privileged, sticky mess of a hippo, but he is also...
Potamus is innocent.
Guilty of cooking weenies over my burning house
and
consuming large quantities of alcohol, all while dancing naked with tribal drums.
But not of starting a fire.
If it pleases Your Honor, why don't we just ask someone who saw the whole thing happen?
Would a Mrs. Gigi Quackenbush Lopez Feinerstein David Peck Wong... Birdman, my tour? What? Please take the stand.
Gigi! Wife, I think. What are you doing?
If you would, please tell the court what you saw that fateful evening when...
Of course.
What the fuck is this? Oh my God.
Harry, Birdman, and I recently got back together. We're married, you know. Anyway, I was returning from my lover, I mean butcher's house, when I saw a small fire on our porch. I saw that hippo just standing there with those matches in his hand.
You mean that in conjunction with the book of matches found at the scene, this testimony puts Potamus on the scene with intent? Nothing further!
I'm having trouble following stuff because it's just so, like, I'm just taken by the strangeness of it all, and I can't, like, I'm not actually absorbing any of the clues or the things that are happening. This is my first exposure to Harvey Birdman, and I'm surprised that I haven't seen this before.
I think I get a cross-examination or something. Right?
Well, no doubt. You need to hammer down, good buddy. You are in the granny land looking for beaver. Watch for bears.
Looking for beaver.
I'll take that as a yes.
Okay, I'll give this another couple minutes. I guess now it's time to examine. And yeah, you just play. You play Phoenix, right?
Oh yeah. Press that button again, again.
Stop.
You do that one more time, honey, and I'm gonna bite you.
Stop.
Let's have a party, boys. Who's next?
Stop.
Oh, is that a goat? Are you just happy to see me?
What?
Come here, Harry.
I thought the monkey sounds were weird. Can this get your stream banned?
Oh, I love it.
Holy fuck, this game.
If it seems that the defendant is holding some...
Well, clearly this album here.
Oops, that's not what I meant to present the court. Wrong thing, wrong thing.
Oh. Well, clearly it's the book of matches here.
This matchbook, found at the scene of the crime, my house.
Sure. Looks like a matchbook to me.
Don't you find it strange that my client would put his own name and phone number on the very matches he used to burn my house and leave them there for all to find?
Not really. He was probably going to give them to some intern.
Nah, I was going to give them to Savannah over at Boobies.
Oh, that's what Boobies is. Oh, that's a purse. I thought it was a place.
No, I mean I was going to give them to Savannah until I saw Gigi. I gave them to her at the weenie roast at your place, Birdman. She asked for them, and I, being a gentleman, obliged. Plus, it's not like I could ever use them without thumbs and all.
So that does place Gigi at the scene of the crime with the Book of Matches. Wait, but why?
Bird girl to the rescue! I found a new piece of evidence.
Oh, okay.
It's a cigarette lighter with the initials PP engraved on the side. I found it at your house, Birdman.
Oh, thanks for that evidence. That's great. For the other side...
A cigarette lighter with Mr. Potamus's initials on it all. At the scene of the conflagration. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, I believe that this is what we refer to as a smoking gun.
Or some people I know call it a lighter.
Something here just doesn't make sense.
Okay, listen, I get it. It's kind of amazing. I'm gonna stop here, though. It's cool. I'm sure there's full playthroughs on YouTube that you could watch. I don't know Birdman, and I wanna, you know, continue doing my, Sunday stream. Someone said, not even until the end. You didn't expect me to stream that whole game, right? Like, tonight? I'm sure it's on Hulu. Yeah, you can find that on Hulu, no problem. Yeah, I mean, again, I am totally out of the loop when it comes to that show, but seeing some of that, I'm like, wait a minute, maybe I should have watched that. Capcom made this, by the way. So, that wasn't Shovelware. I don't know what the hell that was doing in there. I'll show you one more. Here, look, we'll do one more game. This one I was dreading. I got this at too many games, and I was not happy about this. This is actually something I was debating even streaming, because it's another one of those dancing games, and it's probably got copyrighted content in it, but whatever. Game Mill made this game. And it's called Nickelodeon Big Time Rush Dance Party. And... there's fake Jonas Brothers on the cover, and it says, includes smash hit Windows Down. Wii System Update. Never mind. Where is it getting this data from? I didn't even think I was connected to the internet. It's on the disk. Oh. Sorry, we've detected that your Wii is not connected to the internet. Would you like to download an update? And it's just a virus. Okay, it says here, Vinny, Big Time Rush is a real band. I was security for them once when I worked at Best Buy. Wait a minute, you did security for them at Best Buy? What, did they do a show at Best Buy? What are they doing now, 10 years later? Like, what is their careers now? Follow the dancers on screen as if it were a reflection in the mirror. Another very high quality video game. I'm ready. background on this, my uncle was the creator and producer of this band and show. They were very much a real thing and have nothing to do with this game. Wow, look at these animations.
The scenes with Big Time Rush. First up, we're all the Rock Records recording studio.
Yeah, I can confirm this is what it's like in a recording studio. This is what you do. Listen, I'm going to play unrelated music in the background just so things don't get claimed. I don't want things to get claimed, so I'm just going to talk for a second, right? I'm going to talk for a second. I'm going to play something, and I'm going to play it so that it covers up this sound. You ready?
I got a question for you.
Here's the sound.
Last night, you ordered a pizza pie.
There was 8 slices.
Okay. There's 8 slices.
Amongst us two.
So just so you get the visual, I'm sitting here.
Give your honest opinion.
Here.
You're right in front of your 4 slices.
Right, okay.
Okay.
So I ate this corner.
He ate that one first.
Yep.
He ate this corner.
I ate this one.
Right.
He ate that one.
Yes.
Right.
I ate this one.
Yes.
Right.
So when you say you created, your uncle created this band, do you mean that, like, they, like, picked them from, like, a group of, like, robot humans to form the perfect boy band to sell and make maximum profits? I love the idea that there are bands that are created by producers and other people, and it's not like a natural thing that just happens. It's just a bunch of like people in a, like a boardroom with cigars trying to create the ultimate monster, and then like assigning 14 writers to them.
You should have ate the pizza on your
own. Oh, I know it's common. It's just bizarre. It's still really bizarre to me.
That was yours in front of you.
You're wrong.
You chose
you
that
took
side.
My hat.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did.
I ate my
these animations are just so soulless. They're keyframed, I think. But they're real weird and bad.
Stay on your side.
Get your piss.
Stay on your side. It's not proper pizza etiquette.
What do you know about etiquette?
You're wrong, Mario. You're wrong.
It's a pizza!
You're wrong!
No, come on!
So here's the, their songs. Wow, look at those. Why are some of the... The first letter of each song is kind of clear, and then the rest of it is smeared in Vaseline. Count on you. My left ear loves that. Vinny, you have to play Windows Down? Why? Is that their song? Oof. I got my head checked. My HMO checked. It wasn't easy. But nothing it is. No. Vinny, play Boyfriend, I Dare You. Listen, I'm not actually here to listen to their songs, because I can't. This will get blocked worldwide, and no one will ever be able to see this stream ever again. Oh, they actually do woohoo. Alright, wait a minute. If I combine this with Blur... I can probably, like, cancel the copyrights out. I can't recreate that if I tried. Oh, this is just sensory overload, the stream. It's all kinds of fucked. Vinny, I will shoot you if you don't stop playing this, gladly. No, I don't think the VOD's going to be muted. I'll let you know, chat. Tomorrow, I'll let you know if the VOD got muted. But I will, I think they cancel each other out. It's just too much noise. It's just too much noise. I'll try boyfriend, and then I'm going to do a BRB and play different things because I hate this. And it looks so bad visually. Listen, I don't know if the band, whatever, the music, the band, I'm sure they're nice people. I'm sure the music is good for some people, whatever. The game is not fun. And it looks crusty, and the animations look to have been done by an intern. Boyfriend, your boy, boyfriend, your boy. All right. I'm not even playing, and the game is still just happening. There's like no penalty for losing. Oh, look at the people. Look at the cutouts. They're cutouts. All right. That was Shovelware Showcase. I've had enough. I also, again, there's a limit to how much I'm willing to take risks to get not just the VOD muted, but a copyright strike, which is worse. And usually shit like that, like, that's the kind of stuff you usually have to worry about. Them boy bands. So, I'll let you know tomorrow if any of it got claimed. But thank you for watching. This was a weird one. It's a little top heavy. All the good stuff was in the beginning. That's not true. Just the best shovelware game ever. How do you live up to it? It was probably one of the top five or top three, so thank you for watching. Next time I do Shovelware Showcase, I'll have PS2 games, PS3 games, and maybe PS3 games. I don't think I have my PS3 set up at the moment. And also, you know, I have that thing that Jerma streamed, 700,000 games. And I'm considering checking it out, but I'd probably only spend like a half hour on it because it looks just atrocious. I watched Jerma's stream of it, and it's bad, so I don't think I really want to, but it's here. But yeah, I got plenty of PS2, and I especially have a lot of DS games, including Iron Chef America. Boy. All right, everybody, we're going to take a break. Quick break. I'll be back with Devolver's bootleg nonsense, and then I'll do the Flash games after that. So stick around a couple minutes. See you in a bit. Swamp Delicate.